come in a little bit smaller and add a little bit of okay, so now I'm going to come with the green, and I'm going to work the detail of the leaf a little bit with some shading and come up along the edge. And it is a little bit variegated, so you just have to kind of go in this direction, create these little variegated edges. So just working a little bit on the edges to emphasize some of those variegated. And then just along this main vein on the leaf, there is some dark area right in here. So I'm just going to use a bit of a contouring drying method, contouring up along the edge of the leaf, to make it look like it's, and I'm not going to pay too much attention to the other little veins. I might just kind of skirt around the impression of it. It's just too small, and these other veins are good. Okay, and so this, there's some variegated edges along there, and then this has also and I'm just gonna come in, sharpen my pencil up because my edging is kind of losing details, so I want to sharpen so I can get some nice edge on there so you can see a nice crisp line. And then this comes along this way and comes down, and it's darker in this area. And again, along that vein on this side. So you can start to see the flip on the underside of the leaf happening. And there's a bit of an indentation down here. So it goes up and down like this. And you use darks and lights to create this kind of up and down indentation thing happening. So we're going to come back and we're going to add a little bit more color onto this leaf. But just on the underside, just down in here, there's dark. And it kind of looks like it is variegated. I'm not going to spend too much time on that. For now. Now what we want to do is we're going to come back with this purple, and this is a purple violet 136 from Polychromos, and I'm going to add some darker details, so nice and sharp. And I need to get because I'm really messing up my page, making it very dirty. And I have glossine, I'm going to use the glass seam, so make sure that that's where it needs to be. And I'm going to put the glass seam down so that I don't mess it up. I'm going to use the purple, particularly around this area in here, to highlight this dark. Oop, my point just broke. That's pretty normal. And I'm going to pull that up. Look how nice that is for a shadow. And I'm going to do the same on this side. And I'm going to pull that up. For creating this little dark area. And just pull that out a little bit. Like that. And then I'm going to, and I will continue to work on that and build that up. And I'm going to just use this purple. And I'm pressing pretty hard to make some of those darker areas on the apple, right kind of in the front. And then I'm also going to use this to go and do some edging and along the bottom of the apple and some shadowing. Again, I want sharp. And I'm going to start off by fairly dark, and then I'm going to go lighter as I go up for the reflected area. Dark. And then go up and back into base tone up above that. Just to create that reflected area. I'm pulling this purple up into this area and into this. And on this side of the apple, there's a fair amount of reflection going on. So I'm just going to concentrate a lot of this purple more in this area. So that I've got some really nice shadows, and then I'm going to come over and I'm going to I'm coloring it pretty light up in this area in here. Coming over on this area, I'm coloring it pretty light. You can still see the highlights. In this area in here, it's going a bit darker. I'll come back with the red. I'm going to put some blue on there too. So, just adding a little bit of blue onto here. It really starts to darken it up. I'm going to go fairly light with this blue. I don't want to overwhelm because the reference image doesn't have a super, super dark edging. But Just again, really sharp point to do my edge. And I'm going to come up. I'm working fairly light. You can see that it's quite dark now. I'm realizing that the shape of the apple is quite funny. I'm going to go over this area and then darken as I go up. And underneath the leaf, the sharp edge. Remember, you keep turning your pencil to get your edge to stay sharp. And I'm going to make that fairly dark, because then it looks like it's the leaf is popping off the top of the apple or the side of the apple. And I'm going to just gradually fade it out as I move away from that darker area. There is a fairly distinct line on the back side, but it does kind of fade out a little bit towards the front. I'm going to come back over here and I'm going to darken that up, pull that up. It doesn't matter whether or not the blue is coming out, it actually makes it kind of interesting and dynamic. Remember, if you were working with more colors, you'd be introducing. I'm going to use this blue also to start working a little bit on that stem and adding some details and kind of making it look a bit more three-dimensional. And also the blue on that leaf. Edge along that main vein. Come up at the top. I'm working quite slow. Looks good. Underneath. Okay, so we're going to go back and actually I'm going to add some green down in this area, because red, blue, and green make darker, like a dark color, almost black. So I'm just going to come in and add some. Back with this red and start to really develop the shading. pressing a little bit harder with the red just to pop out some colors. Just working a little bit with the orange, just to deal with the edging. And I'm going to put some orange on this little thing here also, but mix it into this blue. Work a little bit on that orange. Now, the reference image, this is more on the greeny side, so to get green from this orange, we're going to have to just kind of come in with a little bit of the of this green very lightly. And just kind of mix it in a little bit. And it kind of creates more of a washy, olivey color. Kind of a dirty, and that's kind of the way that the image is. Now I'm going to pull some of this up from the bottom, and I'm going to add a little bit more of the orange. I'm going to come in on this and add a little bit of the, not liking right now the way the stem is. The color, this green color. Just to tone that orange down, because orange has red in it, and red's a complementary color of green, and then you add green onto that and it looks a little bit on the brown. So if you remember from your color wheel, yellow and blue, it's green. So again, a little bit of artistic license going on here. I am making some of these colors a lot darker. Pressing quite hard. Just along this area in here, because there's a doing now then is just slightly refining it. I'm going to show you what happens if I add that white. White's also used for blending, so it works well for that. And if I come along this edge, and I'm using the contour line again, and kind of pulling it up over on that side. It's a bit much. Come down and tone that down a bit. A little bit too much, but I'll tone that down on that side. So, and then just coming back with this red. So I'm going to use a blender right now, and I'm going to contour this area. A little bit of blue on that because it's quite dark in the image. So I'm going to come with this red along that stem because the stem is much too green, so use a complementary color, red. And it'll just tone that green down, right down. And I have a fairly sharp pencil so that I can edge this quite nicely. The stem comes too close together, so what are ways to actually fix that? I can take a white colored pencil and make it really sharp and try to, oh there you go, bust, I can try to widen that stem out a little bit. So let's see if I can get that to look a little bit more. Pressing quite hard, but my pencil lead is busted again. So. Then I'm going to come on the back side and line behind it. So let's kind of clean it up a little bit and just blend it around a little bit more. Now remember, you notice that I only took the blender towards the end of the drawing. Well, generally, I would take quite a bit longer on these kinds of drawings, but I think this does a pretty good job of demonstrating. How to go about creating. And let's just get that shadow down there a bit more. So I'm just going to darken this area. And gradually press less and less as you go out. And then you can take white and work the white in. And I still don't like this. This is too light. So let me just go with that. I think it's about done. Just gotta kind of leave it like that. If this was, actually, let me just darken that stem out a little bit. Just kind of along one area. So if this was something that I was going to sell, I would probably take twice as long to do it. I wouldn't have maybe so many of these ridge lines showing. And I generally work with more colors than just six. But again, this is just a good demonstration on what you can do with six colors and still have something that's very similar to what the original image is. Okay. So there we go. Hopefully you'll have some fun. And I'll just put my JS. And there it is. There's an apple. Enjoy.